When you think of the Pro Bowl, some huge names come to mind. People like Drew Brees, Larry Fitzgerald, and Jason Witten have all established storied careers in the NFL, highlighted by this end-of-the-year contest between the AFC and NFC. Tom Brady leads the league with 14 Pro Bowls amongst active players. Then there's some players that get nominated a few times in their career when they hit their prime. But then, there's Derek Anderson, the worst Pro Bowler of all time. Before I start, it is important to mention that Anderson was a Pro Bowl alternate who was sent to Hawaii only because Tom Brady declined to play. But even at that, Anderson posted one of the most skeptical stat lines for a Pro Bowl quarterback in history. On the surface, you may look at Anderson's stat line and think, wow, he threw for a lot of yards and touchdowns, so he's a good quarterback. But let's look at this deeper. Here is the average of Pro Bowl quarterback stats from 1999 to 2008. Anderson threw for almost 200 more yards and almost 5 touchdowns than the average Pro Bowler over the last 10 years. However, he accomplished this with 43 more attempts than the average, which is equal to almost 2 more games worth of passing. Another thing to notice is how Anderson was sacked less than half the amount of the average. This means a couple of things. First, Anderson had excellent protection. And second, Anderson was quick to throw the ball and not take sacks when pressure came. And those aren't even the worst stats for Anderson. Anderson's 56.7% completion percentage ranks as the 5th worst all-time behind 3 seasons of Michael Vick and Vince Young's 51.5% in 2006. Now, there's something that Vick and Young had that Anderson really didn't, which was the ability to run. Both Vick and Young totaled more than 500 yards rushing to their passing stat lines, while Anderson ran for a whopping 70 yards on 2.2 yards per carry. Now, let's talk about Anderson's 3.6% interception rate. Anderson threw an interception every 27 attempts this season. While this only ranks 11th worst of the Pro Bowl averages, all the other quarterbacks above him posted higher passer ratings and completion percentages by almost 10 points. The only reasonable arguments for a worse quarterback are Mark Bulger in 2003 and Kerry Collins in 2008. But even then, Bulger threw for more yards and had a completion percentage 7 points higher. Collins had an interception percentage 1.9 points lower and a completion percentage 1.8 points higher than Anderson. So, what does this all mean? Well, these stats clearly show that when Anderson is judged against his fellow Pro Bowl peers, he inevitably falls short. Anderson's Pro Bowl season isn't any more impressive when you see that he only beat one team with a winning record in 2007. The Browns went 10-6, missing the playoffs. But despite leading the Browns to a record they haven't achieved since, those victories came against teams that finished the year with a record of 50-94. His wild inaccuracy was shown throughout the rest of his career, as after an MCL injury in 2008, he lost his job to Brady Quinn. Brady Quinn! Then, Anderson had a little bit of a bounce back and signed a 2-year contract with the Cardinals in 2010. But then, he proceeded to be benched in favor of Max Hall and John Skelton, and those are some Pro Bowl caliber names. To Anderson's credit, he made the worst out of his turn from first to worst. He backed up Cam Newton on the Panthers for 6 seasons after leaving the Cardinals, and even started a game for the Bills in 2018. Then Derek Anderson threw 3 interceptions. And that is how Derek Anderson will be remembered, as the Pro Bowl quarterback who couldn't handle the stress.
My heart and soul into this every single week.
All I'm saying is the camera shows.
I'm just telling you right now what I do every single week. Every single week, I put my freaking heart and soul into this. I study my off. I don't go out there and laugh. It's not funny. It's not... Nothing's funny to me. I don't want to go out there and get embarrassed on Monday Night Football in front of everybody.
That's why I'm asking you why.
I'm telling you right now. We're talking. Deuce and I are talking.
What was the context?
I'm done. Sorry.